One of the other aspects we really enjoy down there is just all the different activities. One of the comments I got after I had my first condo and I met four guys that were at Sonoran Spa, and they're going up the elevator, ask where they're from, and they're like, San Diego. And I'm like, San Diego, what are you doing over here? And they're like, are you kidding me? They said, in San Diego, we can't get to the beach because trying to get down there, find a parking place, trying to get a spot, trying to enjoy it is very tough. Said your sunsets here are much more beautiful than they are in San Diego. And then as they mentioned, they're like, there's so many more activities. They're like, we bring our quads over, so we go quad riding, which I do with my kids and a lot of people. It's one of the big fun things to do down there. The jet skis, you don't have to wear the wetsuits. The water's, you know, warm and nice, you know, compared to the California water. You don't have the big waves, so it's a lot easier to get things like that in and out. You still have the fishing, you still have the snorkeling. You have an island that's about 23 miles out that has about 1,000 sea lions. Take the kids out there, you know, two or three times a year. Sometimes we scuba dive out there or snorkel. You usually see a lot of dolphins out there during the January, February months. A lot of times we see the whales. We've taken the boat out and been right next to the California gray whales. So just a myriad of activities.
Well, some of the things we look forward to are when low tide goes out and we can go and search the tide pools and walk out and see the starfish and bring them in and things like that. The sunsets are just gorgeous down there and memorable. We like the swimming, and the banana boat was always fun because the dolphins will swim right next to you, and it's amazing. It's just a cool thing.
There's so many things to do. The ocean is beautiful. We like to go out jet skiing. We like to ride the ultralights. You can go motorcycling, four-wheeling. Great golf.
I love it from a family standpoint because there's not so much going on. It's not an overwhelming tourist spot. We're able to spend quality time with our kids, quality time on the beach. It is a wonderful family place. You know, our kids are so drawn to the beach. It's their favorite place to go. And it's really safe. It's one of the largest tidal pools in the world, so we're able to send our kids out on the beach and walk along with them in the tidal pools, and they love to look at the starfish, go out collecting starfish and other little sea animals. So I think they end up learning a lot while they're playing, and that's really fun for them. The water is very calm, so our kids are able to just wade out for a long, long ways, and they're just up to their waist in water, and it's very calm water. So as a mom, I feel very safe. We have small children, and some of them aren't swimmers yet, but we're able to just walk along as a family, and I don't have any concerns about the water safety.
I think it's excellent for family. There's a lot of things to do. Parasailing, boogie boarding. I went on the cruises at night, and the dinner cruises, and I've also gone horseback riding on the beach.
I'm learning how to kiteboard. There's a kite surfing school down there where it's like a wakeboard you put on, and that's a lot of fun. There's a local fisherman that will take you out at night to spearfish at night. Pretty freaky, I must admit, but it's all about, you know, new adventures, right?
We have a lot of, well, water sports because of the sea here, and we have several events throughout the year, like the triathlon and
but also the diving, scuba diving, all the water sports.
And then of course there's the Pinacate north of town.
It's considered one of the very few pristine places in the planet.
There are plants that grow out there that aren't anywhere else in the world. There's a great aquarium, fun thing to do, to take the kids into the aquarium and see all of the natural sea life and things that the sea has to offer. So there's a lot to do here. There's lots of places to eat, good music to listen to.
The other nice thing in Penasco is the nightlife is getting much better. They're getting places now that are a lot more fun for the adults and not just some of the college students coming down and so forth. So you can kind of get them married. You know, you can go to Las Palomas now and have a nice dinner, or go down to the pool bar at any time and have good quality food, nice atmosphere there. You can go to a place called Elixir now that's more like a Scottsdale lounge. Then of course there's all this stuff down in the Mirador area for people that want to dance, and you know, Manny's out on the beach that have been there forever. Sunset Cantina across Crossfields Hotel there. It's one of the biggest venues, and one of the biggest items they ever have is when the Roger Klein concert comes in town. And it's absolutely just a blast. About 5,000 people, and everybody knows every word, every song. And even if they don't, they pretend. So just really a fun time. There's a lot to do down there now. And also then with the Acropolis coming in, that I think that will help dramatically, because then you're going to get some of the movie theaters, a little more of the higher-end shopping, items like that. So I think in the next 5 to 10 years, between those things coming in, I don't see this town doing anything but great things in the next 10 to 15 years.